Good morning. It's Monday, February 4th, 2013. My name's Stephen Whiteside, and I'm your host this morning for today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. In the pre-market this morning, coming up to 9 a.m. on the East Coast, stock index futures are down sharply. Dow futures are currently down 80 points. Commodity futures are also below fair value. Well, a complete reversal from what we saw this time on Friday, where we had the Dow futures up 110 points. Now, when I started work this morning a few hours ago, futures were actually flat, but we've seen weakness in Europe in the past couple of hours, and that's put downward pressure on the North American futures. This morning, I wanted to start off looking at some monthly charts. These are handmade charts. They're not on the website, and I don't pull them out too often, but you're hearing a lot of talk about the fact that the Dow is up close to all-time highs, and of course, you shouldn't worry that much about the Dow. It's really the S&P 500 we need to be more concerned about. And the S&P 500 is getting pretty close to previous highs and the potential for a triple top here. 1,500 was our major target, and we're sitting right up there and trading above and below it right now. So we have not broken away from 1,500 just yet, and the previous highs could act as a major area of resistance for the market going forward. Well, let's take a look at a couple more monthly charts, and you can see what has been working. Credit card stocks have been working really well. Water utilities have been working really well. And anything that really pays a dividend or regular income, such as a REIT or an income trust, they've all been doing very well. What hasn't been working? Well, bank stocks, while they've recovered off their 2008 lows, have certainly gotten nowhere near their previous highs. And so here we are getting close to 250 on the Dow Jones Banking Index, and that's a place where bank stocks have reversed in the recent past, and so we need to keep an eye on that level. Gold stocks, of course, have come down over the past few months. They're sitting right on 150. You can see that we traded through the 150 level several times recently, but of course, if we break down below those lows, then 125 would be our next area of support for the gold and silver sector using the XAU. Aluminum stocks have not worked over the past decade, and neither have coal stocks, so two sectors that the market really hates going into 2013. Taking a look at our regular daily chart, starting with the VIX. The VIX had a complete reversal on Friday, so that the futures being up 110 in the pre-market on Friday morning really had an effect on the futures, and so we need to close on Monday above 1377 to give us a new buy signal for the VIX, which of course would put downward pressure on the stock market. The VIX is recent lows down there at 1250. That should act as support. And support on the VIX means resistance on the stock market. Looking at bonds, bonds were lower on Friday. That's supportive for higher stock prices. The U.S. dollar was down on Friday. The euro was up on Friday. So all of those key indicators are still indicating that the market's expecting higher stock prices. Of course, that's not what we're seeing in the pre-market this morning. But the Dow futures being down 80 points in the pre-market does not wipe out Friday's gains. We'll just have to see if we get fall through to the downside once the market opens. S&P 500 had a nice move up on Friday off the upper channel line. We are still trading through 1,500. So the low of the day on Friday was below 1,500, even though we closed higher. We're still trading through it. So we're still stuck to 1,500. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, had a great day on Friday. Looking at the ZAX and the Russell 2000, the ZAX Microcap, they both had great days on Friday. Bank stocks had a really good day on Friday as well. Energy stocks moved up. Gold stocks were actually up on the day on Friday, but still on a sell signal. No change there. A couple of our proprietary indexes, farm equipment and fertilizer stocks, are still holding up very well right now. So we're expecting a little pullback on Monday, but we need to unwind the gains that we saw on Friday to really make a difference. So far, it looks like we're not going to do that from what we see in the pre-market. Looking at commodity prices, no changes on Friday for crude oil, for gasoline, for natural gas, which had an inside day on Friday. Copper was able to move up and make a new high for this move and take out the recent highs. That's bullish for copper. Nothing going on in gold or silver on Friday. No major changes there. Next up, let's take a look at my five stocks, starting with Apple Computer. No reason to change your short position in Apple. Still haven't challenged the open gap there. Looking at the CME group, we continue to move higher. And so if you haven't taken money off the table, you should lock in some profits up here for the CME group. Google had a nice big jump on Friday, and this is the time and place where you want to take some money off the table as we're up at the previous highs here. And so please take the opportunity to lock in some profits on Google on Monday. Taking a look at Goldman Sachs, we finally made it to 150. And so if you haven't locked in profits on Goldman Sachs yet, now's the time to do so. And if you still have a partial position left, take some more money off the table on Monday. Looking at Visa, Visa's still on a sell signal as of Friday's close. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. You can see last week the VIX moved right up to the 200-hour moving average before reversing. And so that's the key line in the sand this week is the 200-hour moving average. The S&P 500 came down to the 50-hour moving average, and so that's our line in the sand to see if we give up the 50-hour moving average this week. You can see we almost got up to our next price target on Friday. Looks like we're going to come back down at the open, back down to these highs here, and we'll have to see if they hold. Otherwise, we may be able to head all the way back down to 1500 on Monday. Looking for weakness on Monday, first sign of weakness is going to be an hourly close. That's 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30, 3:30, below 1506.32, 2748.54 for the NASDAQ 100. The XAU ended Friday on an intraday buy signal. An hourly close below 150.08 would give us an intraday sell signal on Monday. Still looking at the XAU, you can see that we ran up to the 50-hour moving average last week and reversed, and so that would be the first sign of strength. Of course, what I really want to see is a breakout above the hourly flypaper channel. Not expecting to see that on Monday morning. Have a great day, folks, and I'll talk to you again next on Tuesday morning.